And good afternoon, YouTube. So this is my 7x12 horizontal vertical bandsaw, and these are the blade guides. They use ball bearing blade guides on the saw, and this is the movable end. And then if you go down here to the fixed end, I don't know if that shows up on camera, but there's quite a twist in the blade. And what has happened here is these bearings have finally worn out. Probably replaced them 4 or 5 years ago, and that's about as long as they last. And what's happened is this has thrown the blade off, so it's not cutting vertical anymore. And I've got this adjusted as far over as I can, and it's just run out of adjustment range. So I've got to take this one off, and I'll probably take this one off as well, and I'll show you how to replace those bearings. Okay, so you remove that screw and this piece comes off, and the way that adjusts is there's a raised section on the saw frame, and so you can actually rotate this around this bolt here. And in the past I've actually gone and widened out this groove that's in here, so I have a little bit more adjustment range as far as the angle, because there's a raised section that goes on. I can show you that here. Yeah, so this is where the blade guide mounts. It fits onto that raised section there with the screw, and then it lets you pivot a few degrees each direction. And like I mentioned, I've opened that groove up so it's a little bit wider than it used to be, which gives me a little more adjustment range so I can keep the saw blade straight. But as you can see here, those bearings have basically worn out to the point they're not guiding the blade anymore. Like, that bottom bearing doesn't move. This one barely moves, but it's pretty well chewed up. Okay, we've got one snap ring off. Get the other one here. Let's see, you gotta get it around there. There, we got that one off. So there, you got both snap rings off. I put on my bearing or gear puller, and one thing I've done to make it a little bit easier is I've drilled a little dimple in the end of the stud there, just so you can center up your puller on there. And then you got to pull these off. They're pretty tight because they kind of get rusted on that steel shaft there. Okay, so this is my little homemade tool to get this stud for that guide bearing to get pushed out. You have to press this stud out of the bracket there. So I have I think this is a 5/8 inch steel tube. And what you need to do is grind down the end of it there, because it's got to fit over that. This angled part here gets in the way, because you want to have this thing vertical like that. You have to figure out which end is bigger, so that usually the end that's sticking out a little bit is the fat end, and then this is the skinny end. So you would go on like that, and then that goes in there, and you press away. So let me show you what that looks like here. Okay, here we go. I think we're pressing down there. Got to get everything centered up vertical there. Bang! And there it pops. Actually, it's best to push it all the way through. There we go. It popped loose. See if we can get this out here. That's always the exciting part. But there's the pin right there. And then you have this bearing in the middle there. And I think I add a washer in there, if I remember right. I've got to get that thing out of there. Okay, there's the five old bearings. Like, some of those don't even turn, like those two. And then these are pretty well worn out, so you get rid of those. I've got these parts, the pin, and then I find if I put two thin washers on each side of the new bearing, because there's a fair bit of gap in there. If you put the washers in there, it keeps the bearings centered. So these are 10 inner, so that's a 10 millimeter shaft, 26 outer, and then I think they're 8 millimeter thick. So these bearings have what's called a solid polymer lubricant. I think they actually pack the bearings with a kind of a plastic lubricant, and that seems to last the longest. I think the original bearings were a metal shielded greased bearing, but the problem is the coolant gets in here and washes all the lubricant out. But these solid polymer lubricated bearings seem to last quite a while. They're very stiff. I mean, they don't spin at all, but you just stack up two of them on each side, and you can see they're so much easier to go together here. So I'll usually put a little bit of anti-seize on the shafts, and then, let's see, yeah, this is the small side end. So that hole is tight, this hole is loose, so you want to push the pin through that direction. Next time I do them, I might think about doing the ceramic ones, but since I already had bought these a couple of years ago and just had them sitting around just for this situation. So yeah, let me get this back together and we'll show you what it looks like. Okay, there we go, all back together. Everything just slides back together. You just pop the bearings down. I used a little socket to tap them down enough to get the snap ring on. And then this pin here, you can usually tap it in with a hammer because it just drives into that hole, kind of a really light press fit, and get the two washers, one on each side, that way this bearing stays centered, and then we got those there. So now I just have to put this back on and take the other one off and repeat this whole procedure. It's the same thing on the other side. They're pretty much identical, but I'm going to put this back on the saw, get the other one off, swap the bearings out, and then I'll show you what it looks like when I get it back together here.